Hello, my name is Philip.
Hi, I'm Lauren.
Hi, I'm Ella.
I'm Sam.
Hi, my name's Steven.
In recent decades, Lake Okeechobee has been inundated with excess amounts of nutrients such as phosphorus and nitrogen from a variety of sources such as fertilization runoff from the farms and urbanization. These nutrients promote the growth of blue-green algae, which is harmful to the environment and also the animals that inhabit it. It is also disruptive to local industries such as tourism and fishing.
After conducting research about problems in the Everglades, we reached out to a couple members of the Everglades Foundation and learned that we needed to create a device that could test the water flow, water temperature, and the concentration of the nutrients within the water, as well as have a device that was sustainable, durable, non-harmful to the environment, and most importantly, that could recycle the nutrients within the water.
So there's the weir system in which we change the flow of the water to our advantage. Next is the ethanol distribution system, in which we use what many aquarium fanatics have used in the past when they have bacteria problems or algae problems in their aquariums. They'll actually put ethanol or vodka in to help with that. And in addition with that, we are using a modified protein skimmer to cause turbulence, which would then allow for the proteins, the bacteria in the water, to foam up. And these bacteria would have the nutrients and phosphorus, the nitrogen and phosphorus in the bacteria, and we would be able to skim the protein off and then use that as a fertilizer.
After speaking with members from the Everglades Foundation, we were told that we had to measure three variables to be able to better regulate the dispensing of ethanol and keep an eye on the state of the Everglades. These variables were temperature, water flow, and the concentration of phosphorus. We used various electronics equipment to be able to measure these variables.
Hi, I'm here with Dr. Steve Davis, and can you answer me a question?
Sure.
How is phosphorus a problem here in the Everglades?
Well, phosphorus is an essential element for life. We all need it for our bones and teeth, and it's actually in our DNA. So it's an important element for life, but in ecosystems like the Everglades, there's a situation of having too much of a good thing. And that too much of a good thing leads to changes in the habitat, it leads to changes in the food web of the Everglades, and specifically it leads to the collapse of periphyton, which is an important food web base for the Everglades. So when we get phosphorus concentrations that are above a particular threshold, in this case 10 parts per billion, we see the periphyton disappear. As a result, the food web changes, and through time with continued pollution, we see an overall change in the habitat quality. The problem is once it's here, it's virtually impossible to get rid of. So when we talk about improving water quality in the Everglades, we need to solve the problem at the source rather than once it's made its way into the Everglades.
So I'm Rex Hamilton, and I'm here today with the Everglades Foundation, and we're happy to be the hosts for Gulliver as we look together at Everglades restoration. We have our chief scientist, Steve, with us today, and he's been incredibly helpful at interpreting what we've been seeing in terms of the importance of water quantity and water quality here just outside of the park. We've looked at the sheet flows coming from Everglades, from Okeechobee at the head of the Everglades watershed, going into the park. And we've looked at various plants and fish and birds that are impacted by changes in water flow and the quality of the water.
After we developed and designed our device, we reached out to the Everglades Foundation. We had a meeting with them, and they helped us determine the viability of our device, and they told us that it could possibly be placed somewhere in the Everglades, and they were willing to help us deploy it there. They also informed us of the George Barley Water Science Prize, that it's a $10 million competition that they're hosting to solve the problem of phosphorus in the Everglades. They also encouraged us to join this competition in the future. They also were able to give us some funding to help develop our device in the future.